stated that they would be fed, clothed, and sheltered as a result of their work at the foundation's commercial businesses. How is your opponent?
The court ruled against the Alamos. They said workers are entitled to be paid for their labor, at least minimum wage plus overtime. And it doesn't matter if the organization they're working for puts a roof over their head or if they're working out of religious devotion. This church in rural Arkansas came to represent a major affirmation of the Fair Labor Standards Act.
Their businesses were located at the intersection of basically a two-lane highway and an interstate.
Michael Hancock joined the Labor Department about a decade after the Supreme Court decision. Before living and working in Arkansas, he used to visit the Alamo compound.
They had a big truck stop. They had a diner attached to the truck stop. And I'm not exaggerating, the best biscuits and gravy I've ever eaten in my life.
Wow.
I'm a connoisseur of biscuits and gravy, and it was just marvelous.
The secret Alamo ministry recipe is a subject for another podcast. I called on Michael because he used to be in charge of policy at the Department of Labor in the Wage and Hour Division. He was one of the program costs at the residential program. Hello, are you there? For every successful call I made, I probably had another 5 calls that went absolutely nowhere. Alright, so over the course of a full year of calling, only a fraction of rehabs agreed to participate in the survey. Most programs were just not transparent.
field.